I do the most. Roll it, light it, then I go. Pass it to my bitch, watch it choke.
Alright, what's good, y'all? We back with another episode. Today we're talking about how mountains are trees and how mountains are your ancestors. And I know that sounds crazy, but if you look around, it does not sound crazy at all. But I'ma just run through this, make this quick. Now again, I told you when I can, I'ma get all the way down to the personal. So this one of those videos. But I decided to choose this topic first to get more of an understanding of who we are and where we came from. But it's like I want to do it in a good order to where it's like some information isn't left out. But here we go anyway. I'm gonna just start off by saying that it's too many trees out here that's cut for it to be a coinky thing. And it's too many structures out here that look like bodies for it to be a coinky thing. It's time to stop writing this shit off. It's time to stop calling it a conspiracy. It's time to look at what's around you. And it's time to figure out who the fuck you actually are. Because shit gets wild in this fucking world. You don't even know where you at, but I'm done rambling. But I just want to open your eyes to what the fuck is going on around here and what the fuck happened here. Now, if this don't tell you that these were your ancestors, bro, I can't, just back out. I can't convince you. I can't open your eyes because you one of them. All right, but look, we just going to play this. All right, so if this don't tell you everything you need to know, I'm going to just need you to get the fuck up out of here right now. Bro, but look at this. This should let you know it's in your face, my boy. Okay, so she turned, so she was evil, right? Had this dark spirit over, turned back into a island. She was still part of the island. You notice she was molded rock or whatever, you know? But that ain't it. Okay, I came to Google because I couldn't find the video of it, but that ain't it. She laid back down. Do you get it? No, you don't get it? Okay. These bodies are you. Okay, what I'm saying is these bodies are like in some form, these bodies are you. They are your ancestors. They are you. You are the most updated version of your ancestors, grannies, grand-grands. And it ain't gotta be in your fam. But you think it's just a cartoon. This is the best place to find these. But you can even find it in regular movies. It's not even about that. It's about what happened. What the fuck happened? What happened? And it's not even just kid movies. It's everywhere. Like look at fucking Fantasy Island. Look how creepy they made Fantasy Island. That's fucking gross. That is fucking disgusting. It's not even limited to people. Like it goes to animals too. Like this happened to animals too. And I don't know if these are like spirits, like one would say, or like these are actual huge bodies that got laid to rest. Not even laid to rest. It looked like they got slaughtered, if you ask me. But we gonna keep going though. They show you in all the cartoons. That's the best place to put it. But guess who like cartoons? Guess who like cartoons? But imagine that. Imagine you swimming. Imagine you just big boy swimming and a whole, oh my God, you can't even fathom that shit. I can't even fathom that shit. And then it's a lion turtle.
Maybe you can help me. Everyone, even my own past lives, are expecting me to end someone's life.
See, they had to fucking cut Avatar short. 3 fucking seasons? Are you kidding me? 3 seasons? This show was phenomenal. So now I want to get on like the trees a bit. The trees is like what, that's where we went. That was our home. That was like kumbaya. You know what I'm saying? That shit is sickening, bro. That shit is sickening. They chop down everything, bro. They chop down every fucking thing. Look at this shit, bro. This shit ain't even really cool no more. Like, I don't even, like, sometimes, like, getting the information really be fucking hurting a nigga, because, god damn. Look at this shit. And this shit is in Wyoming. And guess what it's called, bro? Guess what it's called? It's called the fucking, Demon Tower. Demon Tower. And this shit gets so deep, bro. It's called Demon. It's called Demon. I'm all over the place right now. But it's called Demon Tower, bro. And the thing about that name is just like, to me, why would you call it Demon Tower if a certain species, it was their safe haven. The trees were the safe haven. They were the homes. These trees were huge, bruh. They were huge. They were huge. Just like, look at the stump on this motherfucker. You don't think that's huge? Anyway, a lot of these trees were cut down. Like, I'm showing you, like I'm dead ass showing you TV. So you can't say I'm watching too much fucking TV. I'm showing you TV. I'm showing you real life. And then I'm showing you personal shit. Do you not feel where I'm coming from? This shit is in me. This shit is in you. You just don't feel it how I do, because I'm a different type of person. But it's called Devil's Tower. If you just have common sense and know that these trees oh my God, we was. I don't get it, man. So I'ma move on. So basically what I'm getting at, you can see that all these trees were sabotaged, right? They were cut down. These trees don't just fall down like this. And the funniest thing about all this shit is some of these trees look like they were fucking cut. They look like they were cut. I don't give a fuck. Trees don't fall down that clean. They don't fall down that clean. It's some that were knocked down. Yeah, you can clearly see it's some that's knocked down. But they don't fall down that clean. These shits were cut. And what is cutting a fat ass tree like that? Back in those times? Are you kidding me? It's a lot of questions. It's a lot of questions that are not answered. But I digress. See, I'm getting a little upset, man. I'm getting a little upset because I know what the fuck these trees did, and I'm gonna get into that. But here's a clip. If you go back and watch this, go back and watch Avatar, and let's talk about the new Avatar that's coming up. Let's talk about the new Avatar that's coming up, since we already on Avatar. Am I right? We're going to talk about two movies. That's basically kind of the same thing. The Way of the Water. All right, right? Now, The Way of the Water, right? Let's, you know that everything is drying up. You can clearly see that things are drying up, right? And shit is about to get big. Shit is about to get real. So you see that all these movies are about water, and where is the water going? Where is the water going? Because it's mega floods all over the world right now, and all the wet places is dry, and all the dry places is wet. But we're gonna get on Avatar. Notice how this Avatar is all about water, right? That's no coincidence, man. That's no coinky dink. They put it in movies. Let's talk about Black Panther. Now, this one too is about water as well. You can see that there's a reflection on the cover. Like, it's the same side. Everything is one, because duality, there's no good or bad. It's just it. You know what I'm saying? But about this, that was just so funny to me. The underwater pyramids, that was pretty fucking funny. And who is this? I haven't seen it, but I'm gonna go check it out. But this guy's name is Namor. Let's figure out what the fuck and who the hell Namor is. I'm sure it's something to do with water. Namor, also known as the Submariner, okay. Is a fictional character appearing in comic books, Marvel, okay. Debut in 1939. Okay, so like I said, pretty much dealing with water. So it's not about Namor. I just wanted to point that out. Back to the trees. I beg you to go watch this movie. This is basically what the fuck happened to our people, if you ask me. And again, they gonna put it in the fucking movies, and it's happened in real life and personal life. But we gonna play this. Destroy all the trees. Now, if you fuck the spoilers. This shit 10 years old. If you look at the movie, you can see that they was loving on the trees. They was loving on that tree. That was like home database. They played around there. They like worship themselves. They love themselves. Not really worship themselves, but you can tell this was home. Shit is. And look how big that bad boy is, though. And when they got all up in the tree, when they got all up in around the tree, they was gone, and just like, you know, we would be. Just like we would be. But, again, I digress. I'ma just get on this last topic that I feel is pretty weird to me. Now, me being where I'm at, living where I'm at, I get to see this shit up close and personal. The thing that I saw that really piqued my interest, it was this place I used to go to. It's called Garden of the Gods. And if you ask me, that place looks just like all these pictures I showed you. But the funniest thing is, I know nobody got an explanation of how and why that place is so beautiful and how it got there. Nobody has given me a clear explanation of how that got there. It's a beautiful place, but when I went to Google and I went to go do some real research on it, and I tried to dig and I tried to get that answer. They gave me all this bullshit and talk about Pike Peak, Beard off and talk about Pike Peaks. I don't give a fuck. I don't want to hear none of that. I want to hear, like, how did this originate? And this is the answer I got when I went to go Google. So we're going to Google this together.
Okay. This place is literally called Garden of the Gods.
I've been here numerous times. Like, it's called Garden. A Garden of the Gods. Are you not clicking? Is that not clicking for you? Because I can't make that click for you. I can say a million words, but I can't make that click for you. Let's look at some pictures, though, for the ones who don't live in that area or whatever. Beautiful, right? Look like a tree might have been cut down. A tree might have just been chopped down and shit. Smaller trees have grown around it. Does that not look like that to you? This is the answer that I got for the name of the place. So when you search Google for the history, this is the bullshit answer they give you. This is how this shit started. This is the bullshit answer. So back in 1850, this is what they say. So back in 1859, when a savior named Rufus Cable saw the tower fins of rock jutting over 300 feet into the air near Pike's Peak, he enthusiastically declared that it was a fit place for the gods to assemble. What the fuck does that even mean? What the fuck does that even mean? One, two, looks like that was there before he got there back in 1859. So what the fuck? What the fuck? That doesn't give me that. I did not move any forward to how this started. We're gonna continue. From this excited outburst came the name Garden of the Gods, which we know this beautiful color blah. That doesn't tell me shit. That just tell me some guy just came down and said, hey, this is a good place for God to assemble. And that was it. That doesn't give me like any good information. And I read the article numerous amount of times. That article, so many articles, but it's not even, it's just about how did that get there? And if nobody has that answer for me, I'm gonna figure out my own way. And that's through common sense, putting this shit together. But that's about it, man. That's all I really wanted to get into on this one. I could sit here all day and just talk about this, but I don't want to make this video too long because I got a lot of shit I want to get off my chest, man. But until next time, man, hold it down. I do the most. Roll it, light it, then I toast.